rappers, the self-soilers, the hominy ushers. Even if you are not ready for the day, it cannot always be night.
Hey, I'm proud of all of y'all, man. This is Dre Kanye, man. I know y'all in the background.
There you go.
Hey,
there you go.
It's Thursday.
Hey, definitely, man. Y'all go out and be great, man. I still ain't figured out how they wouldn't let me subscribe. I tried to put it in.
That's that old head metric. You don't know what you're doing yet.
No.
It's gonna be all recorded.
Maybe a long.
Okay.
We might go live like Instagram or something for like a little bit, but I don't know.
I got you.
Yeah. And hey, you don't know what you're doing, but you're doing it at a prime time. We got our cameraman Zay. You called at the right time.
Hey, that's the universe, man.
Yeah. So you gonna be on the documentary.
Like I said, continue to go out, man. If y'all don't mind real quick, if I can say a quick prayer.
That's love.
Yeah. Everybody bow your head, close your eyes.
Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning. Just want to say thank you. Thank you for waking us up and allowing us to do the things that we do each and every day. Father, continue to make us great. Continue to be a blessing in our lives. As these young men go out and they do their interviews today, allow them to be the best they can be. Allow them to not be nervous about anything, take everything of anything of nervousness, of despair, or anything out of their system. Put greatness into their bodies. Allow them to go out and just have a wonderful time and be the best they can be each and every day in your doing your will. As we ask all this in your name, Jesus. Amen.
Appreciate it.
Excited about Tabiti. About to go pick him up from the airport. Make some great content today, man, and you know, just keep building on this beautiful journey we're going on right now. So I appreciate everybody for tuning in and tapping in with us, man. Super excited. Got Zay on the team, my boy Jay Money, and of course the man himself, AJ Holiday Season. So yeah, man, I'm not gonna keep this thing too long. Don't know what Zay's gonna do with it. Somebody shut it off here.
For American flags are popping up as a symbol of that change. Record high gas prices, staggering unemployment rate, foreclosure. People can't even.
Big day. I'm ready.
I actually don't have a word.
Come on, man. I'm over here getting my hoodie straight. That's a big day. But the wrong tilt.
Good, man. What's good?
Nice to meet you, dog. Appreciate it. Every guy get a little love, too.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. Sure, that we was going to do with the intro question.
Mm-hmm.
Touch like a topic point that I can reference back to. So he did the interview on Fox 5 News with Steph by Stevens. I'd be like, yo, when you were at Grady High School and you said you saw the disparity between your friends where one's driving a Bentley and the other one's taking the buses every day.
Yeah.
How did that fuel you? Because like somebody could see that and just turn a blind eye, but how did that fuel you into what you're doing now?
Yeah.
And how did that get you to the point where you want to give back and now you start at Steph by Stevens where you were given 20% back? And now you're with
it's 20 or 15. He's all right, 15.
He said 15, and then he said, this year we're doing
20%. This is so tough because I want to say that on the pot, like to make him know, like, nigga, we just peeping.
Yeah.
If you say 20, I'm like, I'm on 15?
Yeah,
say that. He's like, shit, they really
did research.
Yeah, because nigga, I was in that car locked in on my phone.
Where did you get your dog from?
I feel it in my bones, man.
That shit ain't true. But we go get this rental. We can kick it at the gym. We can make some like car content, just lit in the car.
I'm trying to call a sex symbol to eat my kids up. They say more money, more problems. Bring on the problems. Bring on the problems. Bring on the motherfucking problems.
What time does he touch down?
8:58.
Fucking problems, hey. Braid it up in my Suizo. Hit him, then I get him easy. Life ain't getting any easier. Flock off, Cito. I know that I'm not in love. She don't love me either.
This action podcast, at the end of the day, all we talking about is taking action and stuff. So everybody got like dreams and goals that they're trying to accomplish. But normally just stop by like the fears or like mental barriers. So what we talk about basically is pushing through that. Because at the end of the day,
live your life, live your best life, all right?
That's all right.
Yeah.
That's
all right. So we trying to spread the good word.
So what is only on YouTube though?
YouTube, we on all streaming platforms. So we on, if you want to just listen to it, Apple Music, Spotify, it's on all that.
It's just hard to find a love that she keep on getting deeper. Who said it's cheaper to keep her? I'd rather release her body and give her away like a feature. You know the procedure. Niggas is preying at God, so we stay with the sweeper. I'm rapping 4L in my 20s, so treacherous. Introduce y'all to the leader. Come to me without a smoke. I like the money.
So, like, I was just in Virginia Beach last week. My girl had her bridal shower. And I was coming out here a lot. Like, my girl's parents was out here before they passed. So, we was out here all the time. But now, shit, not too much. All right, man, for sure. Appreciate it. Yeah, but not too much now. But it's, you know, a lot of all the creatives come out Virginia, right?
There's a lot of them.
Something in the water. Yeah.
That's, are you going to go to something in the water? Or you know what that is?
I don't know. But, like, I do, like, I credit y'all. Y'all got a lot of creators coming. Some of y'all water here for sure. Like, yeah, definitely. No. Like, even just
no,
people,
I'm
behind
saying,
the
you
scenes.
Said something y'all want.
No,
so something.
No,
it's the
festival. I know the festival. But I'm saying.
I get it.
The
plan. Yeah. Like, yeah. Back,
something in the water. Yeah.
Appreciate you, man.
I appreciate y'all.
Flexible and chill.
The thing is, bro, when y'all asked me to be on the podcast, I was just expecting to get on the Zoom the next week. And Caleb was like, they want to bring you. I said, I'm like, for real?
Yeah,
we was dead ass.
At first, like, we see you, we see the schedule, so we was like, maybe Zoom would be like, but then she gave the options, and I was like, why wouldn't we have you?
So Kayla from Richmond.
Yeah, she told me, but she didn't tell me about it till like 2 weeks ago. We've been talking since.
Yeah, she told me I was mad cool. You know, I get temperatures on people by the people around me. Like, if they vouch for you, whatever, that's how.
Was she at cool Fest?
Probably in the back. Work myself. So Kayla, she went to Spelman, came from Richmond, works on all my stuff, but she's super smart. She actually got like 2 or 3 degrees, but I got her, she was my assistant like while she was in school on the side, so I think she's like a psychologist or psychiatrist or some shit, like some major shit, but she's so good. I'll be trying to keep her, so whatever I gotta do to keep her, and if she quits, she gotta give me another one, but you know, I try to put people in situations to win. Like, if I can help you make an extra $50,000, $75,000 a year on the side,
you was giving gems when you got on with Troy and Rashad. Man, not even like the investing part, but just like, yo, if I help you make $100,000, why wouldn't you want me around?
Yeah,
in the room. That's all you just getting in the room, man.
Bro, and you learn so much stuff just from being in the room. Like, I done learned so much even of what to do and what not to do just from being in the room, if that makes sense. Like,
and not even talking, just soaking up game.
Yeah,
right?
Bro, just sitting there. Just and then put it in like, someone once told me, like, you don't have to show everybody you're the smartest nigga there. Because, like, sometimes that shit get intimidating, and sometimes that puts people in, like, a bad position. But, however, like, a dumb person can play smart. A smart person can play dumb, but a dumb person can't play smart. So he was like, you know, you don't got to let everybody know everything you got going on, everything you're thinking. Just, you know, just play your part. So it's like, and I can put the plays together while I'm thinking of whatever's going on. Mm-hmm. Yeah, bro. And it's so crazy. The crazy part is when you start implementing it for yourself. So, like, I'll be talking to y'all or people, and it's like, y'all think I'm saying some profound shit. I'm like, this is just what the motherfucker told me. Two years ago.
Being around the right motherfuckers right there.
Yeah, that's wild.
That'd be the cool part, though, because, I mean, with the podcast called Just Action, so it's like, we really starting to try to implement instead of just saying. That's, like, if we talking about something, it's because we tried it.
Yeah.
And that's where, like, I guess the most experience come from.
It was an epiphany going to Invest Fest and hearing you saying what you saying when you got
that's
on stage.
That's wild.
And then
appreciate
them
it.
Saying what they said, it all made sense. And Mr. Harvey, when he got up there, just do the shit, bro.
Bro,
you gonna fuck up. Just do it.
Hey, dog. Like, if I have an idea, like, this company off the leash, like, I got a hoodie on that. It's our dog brand, right? And I had an idea. I pulled into a parking lot like we doing right now. Pulled out my laptop, pulled out my hotspot, bought everything, domain.
I filed
the LLC. Like, I'm gonna do all that like right then and there. It might have been 20 minutes. And now when I go home, it's like, I bet I already started doing my shit. Now I'm gonna keep it moving. So we started that page. Like, when y'all started Spot?
Yeah,
right before Invest Fest.
Okay, so
like a week before.
August.
Early September, yeah.
So I think we launched our page August 9th. I'm gonna show y'all this. So we launched it August 9th, and basically, like, I think we start, I think we done probably did 15,000 in revenue.
Oh my God.
Yeah, bro, because it's like once you get an audience, once you got a formula, it's simple. You don't got to have a million people to make money, bro. We got 8,000 followers. You feel me? And we doing promotions. We're doing interviews. So people paying for promotions, people paying for interviews, people paying for us to come shoot they stuff. And it's like, yeah, it's a win-win. And now we started a podcast at first. Mm. And we started this page to kind of push the podcast, but the page picked up so much. So now it's like the page is own thing. The podcast is own thing. So we dropped our first podcast episode last Friday. And I was thinking, I was like, man, like, fuck YouTube and waiting to get 1,000 subs. We got like 200 subs. Like, fuck all that. I'm like, man, we're going straight to Patreon. So we dropped our first episode. We got 15 patrons. Like, and that might not be a lot, but that's 15 people paying you $25 a month. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I'm still putting out the content. We still doing the show. So it's just like, you know, like you can just duplicate anything, bro. Once you know how to do something, it happens. You know what I'm saying?
How'd you get so much engagement when it comes to Instagram? Because that's what we were just talking about. Like,
organically, bro. Mm. That's the best part. I should have been shadow banned. And at first we were sad. But it was so good because all our shit organic. Like, and I'm in a community, bro, that's niche and it's nothing like this. Like, it might be two other French Bulldog podcasts that's really doing numbers, but they don't have what we have. Like, I know I partner with any deal I do, bro, try to partner with an A++ partner.
What's that?
So, like, a person A++. So, like, if I'm doing TV, I'm going to try to go for Netflix, Disney before I go to just black mm-hmm. productions, right? Like, try to get an A++ partner. If I'm doing something in cars, I want to be with Ford. And like, I start at the top, then walk down. Yeah, because they know what they're doing, so it's going to increase my likelihood for success. So in the dog game, I know some of the top breeders. I partner with him. Now that I got him online, now everybody want to work with us because he's the top. He give it validity. So it's like, I mean, bro, like our first post, bro, we get a top 30 list in the world. Like, this is. Bro, we got like, that's 89. Bro, that ain't shit, dog. We be having comments like, Kendrick Perkins posted us the first week after. We be having like 400 comments, 500 comments.
I'm telling you, bro, the engagement.
Bro, yeah. And like, that was 26, 4, 38, 19, 1, and 36. And this is just yesterday, mm-hmm. 18. But we be having shit with like
consistency, though. I see.
We be having shit with 300, 400 some comments, 62, 47. And these are promos and shit. Like, I know we got some crazy shit on here somewhere. And then we started doing shit like, dog of the week. Like, we just putting shit out, you know?
So how'd you build your team with content and getting that shit out, or is that all y'all?
So how we did, I mean, it's all us. So, like, for me, I went to my partner on the dog side who does all, you know, is the dog expert. I'm the business media expert on this side. I got a partner on my business media side. He does, like, film, audio, so he's handling production, the cameras, the booking, the crews, anything digital, uploading a podcast episodes. Like, cause how y'all uploading y'all shit?
So that's these two.
That's these two.
How we uploading?
Like, what platform? Just
podcast.
Spotify. Red Circle.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then it takes into everything.
Spotify. Yeah. Spotify, nah. So we do something like that, and then we do YouTube, and then like the Patreon.
I be feeling like the man when I walk through. Ain't saying what you saying when I walk through.
I don't know which direction I should go. Talk to me.
Fried chicken's pretty good.
I love chicken.
Hey, why me walk through?
Y'all created a media company. Y'all aren't creating a podcast.
That's how you said.
So like, y'all are creating Viacom. Y'all are the company, and then the podcast is just like one platform and outlet. So, like, for example, so for us, Off the Leash is gonna be the platform. Man, Best Friends, the podcast. Off the Leash, we'll do your content. We'll come on. You want to promote your stuff? We do that. That's merch, and then the podcast is gonna have its own line, separate line items, and things like that. Thank you, bro.
Appreciate it, bro.
Yeah, so that's how you gotta look at it. So like, and then this is just the first of all the other shows y'all doing, and even like different forms of content. So, for example, like
that's crazy.
What y'all do? If y'all do this every time y'all bring someone in, y'all do a B-roll. Like, you can put it in the episode, but it can also be its whole own piece of content and show that live on its own. So
that's nearly like vision, for us, bro. That's tough.
Yeah, let me see if I can show y'all, motherfuckers.
How long have you been working on this project?
I started August 9th, August 10th.
Okay.
Yeah.
Rolling, getting to it.
Yeah, man. That's the goal.
And it was just so taxing because at the end of the day, like, y'all feel like we don't have time, but we want to try to figure out a way to make this shit scale to, like, stay.
Let me ask you this, because this is something
we
talk about a lot. Do you think you're outsourcing it now because you know the game?
I think it's a mixture of both, right? Like, I ran a shoe company, so I actually
did
my fulfillment and stuff. But it's also about, like, what do you want to spend your time and resources and money on? So, like, for example, Chad from, like, 85 South, they have all this stuff in-house, right? They have a printer do it, but they handle all their own shipping, which is fine because, you know, you have an inventory, you control those costs. You really get to see anything, you get to build it out, get to provide a job.
Yeah.
For us, they're selling on a bigger scale. We're not selling that much. And for me, it's like, I want to have a one-stop shop. So the guy who prints my shirts, sends my shirts, actually runs the fulfillment center. They connected it to my website. So I had a Wix website. I changed my shit over to Shopify just so he can work with it easily. He integrates it. So now they're managing my tracking, my shipping, and all that. So once I get a print, I just pay an order for print. They sell the shirts. Then I pay them their fee for the fulfillment. So if they charge me $10, cares, and I'm making a less margin. I'm not worried about no shipping, no returns, no bags.
So you're not really worried about the margin at all? You're more branding in the beginning?
No, fuck no. It's business. So it's all margin. Okay. It's all margin, but the margin, listen, I'm incorporating the margin into my price. So if he tell me, you know, my shirts are, print my shirts is $2. Buy my shirts is $2. To print it is $1. To add to fulfillment is $5. And tell me fulfillment adds, say it comes out there, $12 off my that they're taking out of my price, right? $12 that I could have had, then I'm incorporating $12 into the cost of my products and the shipping. So now I sell my shit for $60, $65. Not only do I make the money, pay their money, I'm making my shit back and I'm making it off shipping. So it's like, I'm not losing nothing and I'm getting time. And like, my customer, if you want it, you're gonna pay for it.
Yeah.
Yeah,
how you feel about are you familiar with the Russell?
Mm-hmm.
How you feel about that, like, open source system of pay what you want?
I mean, I love how him and JR and their team over there doing it. I love it. It really reminds me of, like, some early Nip shit, like 2012, right? It's just like a new way to make people think. But, you know, for me, he controls his audience. But like, Tech N9ne is rich as fuck. Who knows? I don't know one Tech N9ne song, and he's one of the highest paid artists every year. So what you learn from that is like, how you can control the audience and the fan base, and like, just cater to that fan base. So, and from what I heard him say, he was like, one person pays, if all of us pay $1, it's gonna be someone who feels it's worth $150, you know? So he gonna make it back on that back end. And honestly, for him, you know, He making physical money off his album. Like, he made like $60,000 the first week or the first day. Like, I know people who are not making that at all. Like, and then he worked with the right people. Russ fucks with him. Him and Boogies and Diamond. You know, Boogies and I went to college together. We went to Morehouse. It's crazy. Before Russ even popped off. Crazy. That's why, like, where you were, like, Atlanta. Like, you said going to Atlanta, I commended you. Because, like, you really want to be a place where people, where you can run into.
You just bump into somebody. Hey, why me walk through? How to make a few bands on the road too. I done made a few bands on the road too. People don't know, now I don't talk to. Me and Paul are mini big, he a boss too.
I bet your ass ain't drove a van in a minute.
Bro, what?
I know how it be when you were responsible for the shit. You be trying to focus. All us in this bitch.
Good time.
All us in this bitch talking about, man, we drunk. Boy, we high.
I'm in this bitch locked. Yeah. Name on it. I'm like, bro, man, we good.
Listen, me and my partner's like, man, it's so crazy. Y'all remind us of us because it's like, we'll get a car drive to D.C. Whoever's driving in D.C., the one rule is, you do not, he's the one, you don't say shit to him because he going to be mad. He gonna miss you street. He going to be in the fucking street. We came from the bottom. We used to wear each other. None of my niggas going to fold. Couple pussy niggas told. They ain't my niggas no more. Hold it down for the fold. In the nine with the woes. That's for sure. We won't fall out about shit. Especially not about no bitch. We ain't going to fall out about hoes. Man said get them.
Huh?
Can we get you right with
content? Me? No. I'm practicing.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm that's practicing. I just learned about the FPS, man. I'm excited. I just
learned. Everybody got one.
I just learned about this.
I told him we get him.
Nah, this is OC.
We out here.
So
I'm thinking, we'll have you on the side. We'll have them two in the middle. I'll be over here. So it's all kind of
welcome to the Just Ask Podcast. Introduce us first. We introduce the Beatty Buddies. So I come in that bitch with high energy. You've seen them on EY.
But normally we just go up to the Just Action Podcast and then I break my name down, break them down. This one, we're going to start with you. So we just going to gas you the fuck up.
I bet.
And then
ladies and gentlemen, you see we're in a new location. It's different. It's big. We got the legendary. Atlanta's own. Went overseas to play Lil Baby freestyle in front of everybody.
It did go crazy.
Real deal, holy feel. We got to BD Stevens.
Shout out my label, that's me. I'm in this bitch with TB. I'm in this bitch with 4J. I just pulled up me a A. Real nigga all in my face. 500 racks in my safe. 500 racks to the plug.
If you A, hey, I wish I recorded that. You said, yo, we win every possession. We win the game.
No, that's literally, if you coach LeBron James, that's the only thing you have to say, bro. Just get in the fucking huddle and say, hey, win every possession and we win this game. And then that's it. That's
it. I can do that, bro. What the fuck? I'm still going to do that. I'm finishing top 10. Hell no. You don't think so? No. Top 100.
I'm popping.